What's going on, guys? I welcome you to this video tutorial, and by the end of this video tutorial you'll get to know how to measure information, how information is related to probability, and finally mathematical formula for self-information. To know how information is measured, let's think of a situation. For instance, that you are planning for a class trip with your friends, and to determine what clothes to pack, you might depend upon following weather forecasts. Let's say you are watching news channel in order to get information related to weather forecasts, and let's say the news reader states following three statements. Number one, the sun will rise. Statement number two, there will be scattered rains. And the third statement, there will be a tornado. Now, what is the relative information conveyed to you by each of these statements, assuming that there had been no previous discussion on what weather forecast will be? Obviously, the very first message is very obvious and conveys almost no information. So the very first statement conveys no information because we are pretty much sure in advance that sun will rise. The second message, however, provides information not previously available to us. And the third statement, being very uncertain and rare, gives us the maximum information. And this uncertainty is because tornado is very uncommon in India. So thereby, it's a very rare incident, and hence it conveys maximum information. So, if I were to summarize the previous situation that we had taken, for instance, the amount of information contained in an event is closely related to its uncertainty. And hence, messages possessing knowledge of high probability of occurrence convey relatively less information. And we also note that if an event is for sure to occur, it conveys zero information. Now we can rewrite the above two observations mathematically as, here, if I think of x of I to be an event and capital I of x of I as self-information, what we can make out from the above two observations is that self-information I of xi can be equal to zero if probability of that event x of I is equal to 1. And also, self-information x of I cannot be negative. It can either be greater than or equal to 0. And if there are two events, x of I and x of j, such that probability of x of I is lesser than probability of x of j, then self-information of xi is greater than self-information of xj. And finally, we can also make out one more observation, that which can be mathematically expressed as, if xi and xj are independent events, then I of xi comma xj is equal to I of xi plus I of xj. So right now we have made four observations and we have mathematically rewritten the same observations. So this is our observation number one, that which states self-information will be equal to zero for a sure event or a certain event, and certain events are always associated with probability equal to 1, and our second observation, that which we have mathematically indicated, is self-information cannot be negative, or in other words, it can either be greater than or equal to 0. And the third observation that which we have made is, if there are two events xi and xj such that probability of occurrence of xj is greater than probability of occurrence of xi event, then self-information contained by rarely occurring event is greater than the event that which is occurring with higher probability. And finally, if there are two events xi and xj such that these two are independent events, in other words, there is no dependency between xi and xj, then self-information of xi comma xj is equal to sum of self-information of xi and self-information of xj. Now, by keeping all the four observations into account, what we can conclude is self-information of an event is inversely proportional to the probability of occurrence of that event. And if I keep all these four observations into account, I can replace this proportionality with equal sign if and only if the function is obeying all the four observations. And this function is nothing but logarithmic function. So this is the formula for self-information. In the above formula, the base, that which is denoted by B, is quite arbitrary and determines the unit by which we measure information. If the base B is equal to 10, then the unit of information is Hartley. And if the base B is equal to epsilon, then the unit of information is nats, that which stands for natural unit. And finally, if the base is equal to 2, then the unit of information is bits. Now, suppose we have a discrete information source that emits a binary digit 0 or 1. With an equal probability every 2 seconds, the information content from each output of the source is given as I of xi is equal to log to the base 2 of 1 by t of xi, where I can take on values 1 and 2. We can rewrite the above function as just log 1 by t of xi, where I have dropped base 2 because base 2 is understood, and as a matter of fact, the discrete information source is emitting 0 or 1 with equal probability. So thereby we are having two symbols over here, and probability of getting any one symbol is given as 1 divided by 2. So the sample space over here is 2, and getting either 0 or 1 is only one favorable case, and hence probability of this event is 1 by 2. So thereby I can replace P of xi with 1 by 2. If I do so, I'll have log 1 divided by half. Now this, I can take out this 2 onto the numerator, and I'll have this as log 2. And as a matter of fact, base is also equal to 2. So this is equal to 1. And because we have used base as equal to 2, if the base is equal to 2, then the unit of information will be bits. So thereby, this discrete information source, that which is emitting either 0 or 1, carries information equal to 1 bit. So by now, we got to know how to measure information, how self-information is mathematically expressed, and how information is related to probability of occurrence of an event. If you are having any queries, please do comment in the comment section. Thanks for watching.